talking a little bit about the challenges that go along with doing the Do Health trial. There are a lot of unique elements to this study, which make for a lot of benefits once we get done, but it also makes for a lot of challenges along the way. The three areas that I'll talk about are the study participants, the study setting itself, and the study interventions. So starting with the study participants, our participants are older individuals. Older individuals are a growing part of the population, but they're often understudied. And so the more we can focus on the older people's needs, the more we'll be able to serve the community now and in the future. The good part about studying older people is, as I said, it's going to be more and more important to understand their health issues in the future. They also are very good participants in general. They don't have the same hurries and conflicts from jobs, and so they often enjoy the association with the study and the relationship to study personnel. The difficult part about implementing a study with older participants is that their physical limitations sometimes make it difficult to come back for study visits. And so it's very important that we have follow-up information on all study participants. And some of it can be gained through phone calls, but very often it has to be at visits in the hospital. And so making sure that we schedule follow-ups and do our best to get the individuals back for those study visits is critical to the success of the Do Health study. Second, both strength and challenge is the study setting. So the patients are from across Europe, many countries, many more hospitals. This gives us very generalizable results. It's not just one particular segment, but really will give us information across most of Europe as far as how these interventions work. The challenging part is that when you do a study, you need consistent measurements. The procedures, the instruments, how they're implemented, have to be as similar as possible for each patient. And when you're doing patients at one institution, it's much simpler than if you're doing patients at multiple institutions. And so we make a lot of effort to make sure that study personnel are trained in the same way at all institutions and carry out the exams in the same way. The third challenge is the interventions themselves. So again, as with most things, the biggest strengths are also the biggest challenges. For Do Health, the interventions are vitamin D, omega-3, and exercise. All common, easy to access, inexpensive, and so if the study is a success and any or all of those improve health, we'll have interventions that can be implemented easily throughout Europe and improve health for virtually everybody. It's not a focused segment and not an expensive treatment. The trouble is that those interventions are commonly available now, and so trying to control the exposure is difficult. So we can control the amount of vitamin D in the pill, but then there's sunlight and diet. Omega-3 you can get from the pills, but you can also get from your diet. And exercise, we can prescribe a program, but then daily life involves walking, involves exercise of its own type. And how do we control for that? We really can't. What we do instead is measure it to our best of our ability, and then try to use that in conjunction with the randomized arm. So it's work. Everyone's trying very hard, participants and study personnel, and we're looking to a successful conclusion and findings.